Now, these are the guys I'm gonna kill. I'm not getting much experience from this, and I'm boring you guys, probably. No, he saw me. You saw nothing. Move along. Move along. Yeah! Oh, that is fun, though. I like it. I approve. And then I get winded. Not necessarily because I ran out of breath. Oh no! But because the guy actually hit me with wind. Can I get another Rengeki? That would be awesome. Oh. Those enemies are pretty close by.
One altar down, two more to go.
We did it!
A third of it.
We did it!
A third of it. There's the enemies. Okay, we're on the other side. Not a big deal. A fairy's orb? Really? You send me out here for a fairy's orb? You know what? I'll let that go. You can actually make surprisingly sharp turns with this bike. It's just a matter of figuring out where you're going next. We're going... Let's go this way. No, I can't tell. I'm lost without my mini-map. Now, if you saw that, the guy to the left actually saw me. But I did that. I attacked anyway. Once again, had I tried to go after that with my bike, that wouldn't have lasted very long. You know, these are water-type enemies. Should I be hitting them with water? Are they even water-type enemies? Maybe they're not. Maybe that's wind. What counters wind? Is it earth? I think it's earth. I'm pretty sure this is the same elemental system as was in the original Dot Hack games. So I think it's fire counters water, water counters fire. Then I think it's wind and earth. I think. I don't know. It's been a while. I was never too big on the elements and stuff anyway. Especially in this game, where I just kind of smack stuff. I mean, elements play a role, but Haseo is much more a melee than he was, than Kite was. And I rather like how Kite was so adaptable. I mean, you can do stuff with Haseo, but you jerk. You can do stuff with Haseo, but it's not the focus. So I'm probably long going to forget my elemental wheel here soon. Yeah.
I guess we won.
That's two now.
Is everyone okay? Tell me if you need healing.
Yippee! We won!
And a return feather. So I'm going on this quest for items that I could buy in town. Now, let's see here. The last one is going to be back here somewhere. Yes, down here, that's it. Now, where down here is the question. I don't see any enemies. Is that a lucky animal I see? Come here. Now, most of the lucky animals, as I mentioned before, are named after mythological beasts of one form or another. I don't remember Fate Worm being a mythological beast, but maybe it's just some interpretation or reading that I'm not up on. Yay, money. Oh, it's up top. Okay, I get it. Well, act then. This is our third one. Which way are you guys facing? I can't tell. You're facing me. That's the way you're facing. Can I sneak around you? That would be kind of awesome. Yeah! Oh, completely unnecessary. But I'm willing to spend some time and fight an enemy. Just so I could ram him from behind. Bonus points for the Rengeki. This fight has been worth it already. Ooh, my morale gauge is full. Heck yeah.
Wow, we did it.
Well, that was fun. Now on to what I'm supposed to be doing, which is going up here and fighting a dude. Them's the ones. Now, I have my morale gauge. I'm going to save it just in case, because these guys are weak enough, I'm not really going to bother with an awakening. But Rengeki is always necessary. No, my gauge isn't full! You have a little red bar above your head after you use an ability. You can't use another one right away after it. So you can't use, like, two abilities back-to-back. And I leveled up and stuff.
That's the last one.
We did it!
Yippee! We did it!
Yay! Now, where is... There it is. He's... God dang it, I'm taking my item for this. Now all we have to do is go back and we're done! As soon as I remember how to drive a bike. Where is it? There it is. Alright, now where is our... Man, you can slide sometimes. I have an email. Good for me.
Ah, I get it. Take it.
We're a bounty hunter and stuff now. And we still have two more of these to go, so let's go with the Steam Scientist's invention next. Obtain memory. I guess we'll learn more in a minute. Not that dangerous.
Take this.
So we just set the items on top of the hills, right?
A robot, huh? Oh, I'm getting all excited!
Doesn't sound that bad. So let's go find us a Knuckle Man. A guy who runs around punching things really, really hard.
So, where is the Knuckle Man?
Let's look for a hill first.
I can't wait to meet the robot!
I don't think he's friendly. So if you look at our map here, Knuckle Man is standing right there in the center, and we see three hills, so we just need to go drop these off at the top of the three hills. Considering I'm a bit over-leveled, I actually kinda wanna try this anyway. And see what happens. But considering I've been wasting plenty of you guys' time already, I think I'll probably skip some of these battles. Get right to the meat and potatoes. The meat and potatoes of a mechanical man. Now, the enemies surrounding the little circle things tend not to really chase you. They just kind of wander around their little area. So you're generally pretty safe.
This'll be quick.
So this is hill number one. Weak enough enemies, this shouldn't be a problem.
So, this is the hill, right?
The first one is set!
All right! One down!
We can do more damage to him now. Heck yeah! Now from here, we can run downwards and find Mecha Grunty. Hey there, little dude.
It's that again.
Course unknown. Fuel insufficient. Functions shut down. Emergency landing. Passing life form detected. Begin fuel request. Beep. Please inject chin spheres.
I got 15.
Chim! Chin spheres! 120%! Resupply complete!
Fly on, Mecha Grunty. May one day you find what it is you are looking for. Now you see a little animal running around over there. That is a lucky animal, but I think that one may just be hard to tell from here. Can I target it or something? Oh no, he's running. Worry about him in a minute. If that's a lucky animal, then I'm gonna go for it. But some of these little dudes are unlucky animals. Now, if memory serves, the unlucky animals actually chase after you because they're mean. So, well, let's find out if he is or not.
I'm fast, but you're a flash. Hooray, hooray! Here you go.
No, I guess that was a lucky animal. Item set, item set. I never use support. I sell those immediately. Recovery I have plenty of, so I guess I'll go with attack. Okay, well, regardless, we're going for down here. Because there's another hill nearby. If I can sneak by these guys here. Oh no, I passed by. It's back here. No! I can't steer. Oh well. You can stop casting that spell right this second. Now, are you guys water or wind? We'll have to wait and see when I'm cast a spell. Wind, alright. Same enemies as before then.
Two down! Only one more to go!
Hooray! That's two down!
Well, defense decreased, attack decreased. I don't especially know what the last one to decrease is, but considering it's on an island, we're going to have to pass by Knuckleman to get to it in the first place, so we may not get the chance. Now, Knuckleman is right there. So we'd have to go over there. You know what? Let's just give him a go. See what happens.
Finish this quick! Don't cry later!
Now you notice he has a giant red bar underneath his equipped underneath his HP up top. That is actually his armor. So we have to do a decent amount of damage to blow off his armor before we even get the chance to hurt him in the first place. Now, you'll notice there are, I shouldn't say you'll notice, but there are a couple enemies in the game that do this. In different ways. In Knuckleman's case, it's armor. No, oh, I almost had it. There we go. Armor gone. Now we can actually hurt him. Guard, guard, guard! You know, Gaspard, how about you, like, not stand right next to him? Can I change how you act or something in the middle of battle? No, not that. Guess Gaspard just isn't the kind you want around for a boss fight. And yet another reason why I kind of prefer having a melee in. Somebody else that can take a hit. And we got the memory module.